What is going on, guys? It is Marksman here, and we are on the jungle map, this Mayan temple dig site, whatever the hell it is, called Instinct. Not a very good search map, but you're going to see me play it here today with a cloak hover combination with the HBR. That's not the topic of the video, though. If you want to learn how to play Instinct, go ahead and give this a watch. Also, give it a like if you enjoy, but the topic is about the top rifles in Call of Duty. We're going to go from the franchise, from COD 4 up to Advanced Warfare, in the best rifles, in my opinion, of course, in the game. You guys can agree, disagree, feel free to leave a comment, and let's get right into it. COD 4 was the M16 powerhouse burst weapon. This thing was a monster, and we're gonna actually bring it up similar. We're going to compare it to the M8, because a lot of people actually didn't play COD 4. It's comparable to the M8 of Black Ops 2, except even better. And it's like M8 pre-patch, if you played that, if you know what I'm talking about. If you don't, then that's okay. We'll talk about it in a bit when we go to Black Ops 2. Moving past COD 4 into World at War, we have the M1A1 carbine and also the STG44. I think they're about even. The M1A1 was better for a burst weapon or for a single shot weapon, but you could shoot it very quickly. The only issue was in World at War there was a mod blocking system, so like I would get blocked really quick on my trigger finger because I shoot too fast. And the STG44 is a fully auto, decently low recoil rifle. So the STG was a good, I would say, second best rifle if you couldn't shoot the M1A1 without getting blocked or without, you know, using just a single shot weapon. So I'm putting those both in there. Now going into MW2 after World at War, this is the hard one because MW2 we have three really strong rifles. The TAR with FMJ was extremely powerful. The FAMAS was, which was a three burst weapon, slow fire rate though. And then we also had the ACR, which was really high fire rate, pretty strong weapon, and almost no recoil. So if you could hit your shots, that gun was godlike. And now that's, I can't tell you which is the best there. Out of the three, I think the best one would probably have to be the ACR. Not for me. I didn't like the ACR that much because I just had issues with no recoil. But out of the three, I think on average, you'd see the ACR the most. And it was one of the best for any given player, you know. Moving past Modern Warfare 2, we go into Black Ops 1. That is easily the FAMAS, as you saw in all the competitive Black Ops 1 matches, if you watched back then. FAMAS City, especially after the AK-74U nerf in that game, it just became FAMAS City. Like, it was nothing else you'd find. It's a really fast-firing rifle with decent recoil, so it made it just a strong contender, close-range, mid-range, and long-range. After Black Ops 1, we have MW3. I think it's fairly easy to say the ACR was the best MW3 rifle if you watched any competitive again or if you played it, which I did a lot. I would say the ACR was really good mid-long range. Close range could be sketchy because it didn't have a super high fire rate, but it was a very strong weapon. So it did have a decent kill rate or kill percentage close range up against like the MP7, PP90, things like that. So the ACR was easily the MW3 rifle like you wanted to use. It was a monster at mid to long range, especially. Especially if you could use impact. A lot of people didn't try impact. I did as a search player. And it would melt people through walls. Like, the impact made that thing just blow through walls, no problem. Black Ops 2, though, which is relatively recent, as you've seen a lot of it on my channel as well, most likely. We have a tie, I think. The FAL and the M8A1. Now, I put it as a tie. FAL, I think, is a better weapon. But it's also a burst weapon. It's not easy to continually fire over and over and over at a good fire rate all the time. So the M8 I put there. Plus the M8 was also a more reliable weapon in my opinion. The FAL, like I said, it's a little difficult to go with. It was definitely better if you have a really good trigger finger and you were great with your accuracy on it. But if you saw me play, most of the time you saw an M8 when I was trying and not an FAL. So the M8 for me is like my go-to weapon, and I think that's why I kind of put them in the same area in terms of skill and like best overall rifle. Let's see, going into Ghost, which I absolutely hated, I think you can probably give it to the Remington. I personally used the AK-12 a lot in Ghost, and that was because I felt like it packed more of a punch than the Remington. But the Remington was good, and I think the only issue the Remington probably had was its clip size, which kind of sucked. And then, finally, going into Advanced Warfare, I think you guys can probably take a guess on this one. It's the BAL. The BAL is the overall best weapon in the game. Obviously, some variants can change here and there, like if you have this gun with the Insanity, it might be better than your regular BAL, but if you're just comparing regular rifles, nothing special about them, the BAL is going to win that without any guns contesting it. There we go. That's better. Like I said, though, if you guys disagree or you have another gun you'd like to throw in, leave a comment. I will talk to you all later. Thank you for watching, and I hope you all have a wonderful day or night wherever you are in the world. Nice work, Sentinel.